everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for another episode of BTS Gems. We are continuing our conversation with executive leadership coach and best-selling author Alvin Day about extracting our greatness. Alvin, let's dive into this week's gem. We're looking at the importance of picturing our success. I know how important it is. I don't know if all our viewers do. So there is a principle that you shared in your book, If Caterpillars Can Fly, So Can I. And that is the WYSIWYG principle, which is key. And I'd like us to share it with our viewers. First, what does WYSIWYG, WYSIWYG, translate to? And what does it mean?
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, hello, everybody. I'd like to talk with you about this subject. It's one near and dear to me, WYSIWYG. For some of you who were born after the computer was made, and I'm a little over 29 myself, you may have to go look this up on the internet. And it's called WYSIWYG. What you see is what you get. There was a time when the computer was just invented back in the early 80s, the desktop computer, where you had a black and white screen and you had to type in numbers and codes and simple things that were just information, which when they invented the printer would be driven to the printer and then the printer would get the picture right because the printer was programmed to take those instructions and create a layout and a font and a formula and a picture. But then as the computer age developed, they learned how to create on the screen what you will get on the printer so that you could then make decisions. Instead of having to print six versions of it, you could get it just right and print exactly what you see. That's called what you see is what you get, WYSIWYG. What a remarkable thing it is that this is exactly how our lives work. When you operate in the black and white world of hopelessness and depression and sadness, all you see is these little codes, people. They're saying things, they're taking things from me. It's a meaningless morass. But when you develop into a being who can visualize the end product, then you can have the end product. What am I saying to you? When you lie down in your bed at night and you're alone with your thoughts, what kind of thoughts are they? Are they thoughts of gloom and doom? Or are they thoughts of dreams and hopes and magnetic expectations of wonderful things you're going to achieve in your life? Because I tell you that if you see doom and gloom, tomorrow is more likely to be rainy and ugly and bad. And if you see hope and greatness and wonder, even when it's raining, you can see the skies. It is really amazing to me. I was in Cincinnati, Ohio, and Cincinnati is known for having a fog. There's always some ugly cloud, and it's just murky, especially in the winter time. And one morning about 7 a.m. I was on my way to see a client in Chicago, and it was ugly and the plane took off. I love flying. You'll hear me talk about flying a lot. If caterpillars can fly, so can I. Born to Fly, I have an audio program about that. But it's my experience. The plane took off and it went through the clouds. And as it went up, I looked down and I saw this little fog like a hog's breath sitting over Cincinnati. And it was glorious up there. I could see for hundreds of miles and it was crisp and clean. So when you're under the thing physically, if you can visualize it, then you can experience it because it's never totally dark. There's a light somewhere. What do you imagine? What do you dream? What do you think? What do you say? What you see is what you get. So long before you have it physically, you'd better be able to see it mentally, emotionally, in your thought life.
Thank you so much for this, Jim, Alvin.
You're welcome.